أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. One of the most painful and difficult things that happen in a family is when the children deviate from the path set forth by the parents. Muslim parents want their children to turn out as good Muslims, as people who follow the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And sometimes that doesn't happen. Sometimes the children deviate from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or they deviate from a path that their parents had imagined for them. Now, of course, our children are independent human beings. They will charter their own path in life. But generally speaking, as Muslim parents, and even non-Muslim parents have the same idea, whether they are Christian or Jews, they want their children to come out of the same faith. They want them to hold on to some of the cultural norms, whatever that culture may be. But sometimes that doesn't happen. And I often get phone calls from parents who are crying, who are in despair, who are tremendously saddened because their son or daughter no longer is praying, or their son is drinking alcohol, or their son decides to marry a non-Muslim woman, or and so many different things that can happen. And this is indeed, when it happens to a family, is indeed tragic. Because what happens is the parents begin to think that it is their fault. So they are overcome by a tremendous sense of guilt that somehow they did something wrong in raising their child, so that they came out different than what they thought the child would come out to be. And that is truly tragic. I understand where it comes from, because ultimately we are the ones who raise our children. So we expect that the product of our efforts will come out a certain way. But sometimes we forget, number one, that our children are different human beings than us. They're not going to come out exactly like us. They are going to have their own path in life. Secondly, we forget that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who guides people, not us. Allah guides people. We don't guide people. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he wanted his uncle Abu Talib to become a believer. And yet he didn't. His uncle Abu Talib raised him. His uncle Abu Talib protected him even after he became a prophet and left the faith of Abu Talib. He still protected him till the last day of his death. And Allah told the Prophet ﷺ, you cannot bring guidance to those you love. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives guidance to whoever He wills. So, it's an important thing to remember that concept. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us examples of parents who were in a situation where their children did not follow their path. And these parents were better than me and you. They were prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I want to share with you the story of Nuh alayhi salam, one of the great prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nuh alayhi salam received the message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to invite the people at the time to believe in only one God, to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But even though he lived hundreds of years, only very few actually believed in what he brought forward. The vast majority of people did not. And he thought that his son was following on his path, that his son was a believer. Yet it turns out that his son was not a believer. And so when the flood occurred, because Nuh alayhi salam was given an order to build a ship so that he and all the believers could come on the ship, and then Allah was going to bring a flood and destroy the entire world, the entire non-believing world, and Nuh alayhi salam and those who were believers would be saved by being on the ship, he wanted his son to come on the ship with him. But his son didn't. His son was foolish. He said, I'll find a mountain to climb or a tree to hang on to. He didn't realize that everything was going to be destroyed. I want to read to you the ayat that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes this story in. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, من بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وقال ركبوا فيها بسم الله مجراها ومرساها إن ربي لغفور رحيم وهي تجري بهم في موج كالجبال ونادى نوح ابنه وكان في معزل يا بني اركب معنا ولا تكن مع الكافرين قال سآوي إلى جبل يعصمني من الماء قال لا عاصم اليوم من أمر الله إلا من رحم وحال بينهما الموج فكان من المغرقين وقيل يا أرض ابلعي ماءك ويا سماء أقلعي وغيض الماء وقضي الأمر واستوت على الجودي وقيل بعدا للقوم الظالمين ونادى نوح ربه فقال رب إن ابني من أهلي وإن وعدك الحق وأنت أحكم الحاكمين قال يا نوح إنه ليس من أهلك إنه عمل غير صالح فلا تسألني ما ليس لك به علم إني أعظك أن تكون من الجاهلين. He said, embark in it. In the name of Allah shall be its sailing and its anchorage. My Lord is indeed forgiving and merciful. And so it sailed with them amidst waves like hills. And Nuh called to his son, who had kept away, O my son, embark with us and do not be with the disbelievers. So Nuh alayhi salam, the waves are like mountains, they're like hills. And Nuh calls on his son who has not yet embarked on the ship and he says, come with us on the ship and do not be with the non-believers. Now realize he did not say do not be one of the non-believers. He said do not be with them, meaning in physical closeness and proximity to them. He still did not realize that his son was a non-believer. He said just don't be, come with us. He didn't say min al-kafirin, wa la takun min al-kafirin, don't be one of the non-believers. He said don't be with the non-believers. There's a difference. The son said, and he said, I will take refuge on a mountain. It will protect me from the water. He said, there is no protection from Allah's decree today except for him on whom he has mercy. And the waves surged between them and he was amongst the drowned. He meaning the son. So the son didn't realize. He said, oh, I'll go to a mountain and that will protect me from the flood. Nuh again reminds his son, there is no protection today from Allah's decree. And the waves surged between them and the sun drowned. And it was said, O earth, swallow your waters, and O heaven, clear up. And the waters receded, and the event was concluded, and it settled on the Judi, and it was proclaimed, away with the wicked people. And Nuh called to his Lord. This is how we know that Nuh did not know that his son was an unbeliever. He called on his Lord and he said, oh my Lord, my son is of my family. And your promise is true. He didn't say to Allah, you violated your promise. Allah promised him that the believers from your family would be with you. We will protect them and rescue them. So Nuh did not, this is part of the etiquette of the prophets and how they addressed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He did not say you didn't fulfill your promise. He said, I know your promise is true. In other words, he's kind of inquiring, what happened to my son? He kind of got drowned. He said, oh my Lord, my son is of my family and your promise is true. And you are the wisest of the wise. Once again, This is part of the etiquette. He's telling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, maybe you have a certain wisdom in drowning my son. So he's deferring to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah responds to Nuh alayhi salam. He said, meaning Allah said, O Nuh, he is not of your family. It is an unrighteous deed. SubhanAllah. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala similarly speaks kindly to the prophets. He didn't tell him, your son is a kafir, your son is a... No, he said he did a bad deed. Of course, we know it's not a bad deed. He was an unbeliever. He did a bad deed. So do not ask me about something you know nothing about. So he didn't even know. SubhanAllah. I admonish you lest you be one of the ignorant. Nuh alayhi salam is one of Ulul Azm, one of the great and strong prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And yet he could not bring his son to become a believer. And his son drowned in the waters of the flood. And he didn't even know. He asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, my son is one of my family, why didn't you rescue him? Allah said, don't ask about things you don't know about. Your son was not. He did a bad thing. He didn't tell him. That's the kindness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how he addressed an emotionally distraught father who just lost his son. He didn't say to him, oh, your son is terrible. He just said, your son didn't do a good thing. That's the kindness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the beauty of the Quran, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says things in such a way that are so eloquent and so beautiful. Different topic. But I must comment on it as we read these beautiful ayat. So for those of you who are having trouble with their children, remember, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in charge. Sometimes our children deviate from the path. Sometimes they do things that we don't agree with, that we know are wrong, yet they don't quite recognize. But that doesn't mean they're going to be that way for the rest of their life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there and He can change their path in seconds. I want to share with you in closing a small story from the time of the early days of Islam. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu at the time still was not a believer. He was very tall and he was very big and nobody could argue with him in Mecca. He was a tough guy, almost like a gangster. One day he was walking in the streets of Mecca, and there were two early believers, a husband and a wife. They were inside their home and they were looking out the window and they saw Umar walking by. The husband tells the wife, I really wish that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would guide Umar and that he would become a believer. I wish that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would guide Umar and that Umar would become a believer. Now, Umar has a reputation. He's a gangster. He's a tough guy. The wife looks at her husband and she says, Wallahi, by Allah, the donkey of Al-Khattab, because Umar, his father's name is Al-Khattab, Umar ibn Al-Khattab. She said, Wallahi, the donkey of Al-Khattab will accept Islam before Umar accepts Islam. I mean, a donkey is not going to, it's impossible. She's saying it's the last person in the world who would ever accept Islam would be Umar. The next day, Umar accepted Islam. SubhanAllah. Never lose hope. Never lose faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If your children are away from the path, make a dua for them. Keep trying to advise them. Keep trying to help them. But most importantly, strengthen your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The dua is the only thing that can change the course of events. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give them guidance, to help them. That's your true way out. And remember, you're not alone. You are with Nuh. Same faith. Don't feel sad. Don't feel guilty. But turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه يغفر لكم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.